It's a sunny day out, and whenever it's sunny, not only is it a good weather day, pero dito sa SkyPod, nagsa-celebrate din. Ako lang, hindi nila alam. Ako lang nagsa-celebrate ng konti. Because it means that we're running on free electricity. And meron akong papakita sa inyo, guys. This has been our bill for the month. Negative 3,273 pesos for this month. And we've been doing this for the past 2 months because we've been using solar here in the SkyPod for over a year. This app from our grid supplier. Nakita natin, sa 2022, this is ano bang 9? September. September is 3,000. Meron kaming fluke month na 12,000. But eventually, nag-zero out siya. So, we didn't pay the bill for September and October na. Zero na yung bill natin. So we used to have about 20 to 30,000 per month here at the SkyPod na zero out natin. Pag-usapan natin how we set up our solar system here at home. And more importantly, ano ba yung ROI and was it worth it? So the dream for the SkyPod was always 100% sustainable energy, and this is our solar setup right here, which now achieves that. If you watch our previous solar video, hindi ganito karami yung panels natin because we did a few things. Meron pa rin yung original hybrid system natin, the one that's connected to the battery, but meron din tayong dinagdag na mga panels na grid tie, which is also net metered. Now don't tune out muna. Pag-usapan natin yan lahat in very, very understandable terms, and especially kung ano ang advantage nitong lahat. So we'll take a tour of our solar setup. Okay, first stop on our tour, our solar tour, is the panels. So we have about 20 kilowatts of panels right here. And I think the biggest advantage of the SkyPod is we're just one level. So we have a big, big roof area that we can cover with as much solar panels as possible. But I get a lot of questions. Anong gagawin ko if party shaded yung roof ko, my trees or buildings beside it, or even if maliit yung area ko? Our setup here is fairly straightforward, but you can use what's called an optimizer. An optimizer like this. This is from Huawei. And what an optimizer does, especially good quality optimizers, is it increases the efficiencies of each solar panel. Now, putting this can actually yield up to 30% more energy. So this will be installed in each and every panel, and this built-in energy optimizer will be perfect for those with smaller roof areas, making your solar panels more efficient. Or even if you have roofs na different angles, there's a perfect angle facing south yung panel. But if you don't have that luxury, this will really, really help make sure that you're producing as much energy per area of your roof. Now, this video is sponsored by Huawei, but we've been using the Huawei system even before they reached out to us, and we're fairly happy. So yung mga batteries natin, yung mga inverters natin, is all Huawei. I'll show you guys later. But this particular one, maganda din siya, because this has an app connected to it, and you can monitor now each and every single panel kung ano yung performance niya. So kung may sira na panel, kita mo agad, uy, may problema tong panel. It's not as efficient as it could be. So, yun yun. Now, apart from that smart monitoring, this Huawei optimizer also has active safety. So it can quickly shut down the electricity that's produced by the solar panels up to a safe 30 volts in case na may mangyayari. So for example, maintenance, installation, or even in case of fire, automatic na to siyang mag-shutdown. So this is definitely something to consider for your setup. Okay, so that was the solar panels, pero there's more to it than just the panels themselves. So sama tayo, we'll show you around with our inverters, batteries, and all that jazz. So this is basically the main setup for the SkyPod. So nag-start tayo with the solar panels, and this is our hybrid system. It goes to this Huawei inverter and goes to this Huawei ESS. So ESS means that it's an energy storage system or a battery. So meron to siyang management system dito, and these are modules of the battery. Each one is about 5 kilowatt hour, and we have 1, 2, 3, 9 of these here at the SkyPod, meaning we have 45 kilowatt hours of battery. Just to make sense of that figure, pwede na kaming walang generator. Ito na yung nagiging generator namin. So not only does it save us electricity at night, kasi when the sun is not out, ito yung ginagamit namin. Whenever there's a blackout, that one, tawag nilang backup box, will switch from the grid energy to the battery energy. So every time there's a blackout, mafe-feel lang namin na magfi-flicker ng konting-konti yung mga ilaw namin. And now we're running on battery power. So this is something that I learned from Typhoon Odette na mas maganda to. The initial backup would be the battery just so that hindi siya maingay, hindi maamoy, and safer din kasi battery. So the ESS system from Huawei came pre-charged. So plug and play na talaga, no more waiting for this to be charged. But what I really appreciate about this is yung depth of discharge niya, 100%. Depth of discharge means that ano yung magagamit mo sa sinasabing rating. So for example, 5 kilowatt hour, some batteries out there, ang magagamit mo lang is 50%, or the newer ones, mga 80 to 90% of that. But this one, meron siyang optimizer na kaya talagang when you say 5 kilowatt hour, 5 kilowatt hour talaga ang magagamit natin. So that is actually a money-saving thing. This also comes with electrical protection, so nag-auto shut off to when there's a problem. And meron din siyang structural protection, so this is rated for mga bumps or even if you put one in your garage. Or even protection against water jets. So for example, umuulan ng konti, safe to. So even in our setup, nababasa to ng konting-konti with the setup. We chose this setup because kailangan kasi as cool as possible palagi yung mga battery. Just like our cell phones, pag palaging mainit, nasisira yung battery. So this one may breeze talaga dito. But not only that, meron din daw to siyang built-in firefighting protection per module. So just in case yung knock on wood happen, automatic siyang mag-e-extinguish itself. So safety-wise, that's why we chose this. And truly, the real reason why I chose this is ang ganda niya tingnan eh. High-tech na tingnan. This has a lot of certifications. This actually passed the Germany VDE certification. That's the strictest certification in the residential storage industry. So, ako mismo, kampante ako. We've been using this for, I think, 1.5 years now. No issues at all. Meron pa siyang app na makikita mo yung charge level niya. Or even, you can just look at this. Makikita natin na fully charged na siya. It's still around 11:30. Pero puno na yung battery namin. Which, pag puno na to, dito na magne-negative yung bill natin. So, let me explain. Okay, so creative lang tayo to explain yung system namin dito sa bahay. So, we have two types of system. One, we initially had a hybrid system. And then, we added a grid tie system para mag-zero at mag-negative yung bill. So, hybrid system means that there's a battery and you're using the battery and the grid. Itong tripod natin is from our power provider. So, it uses a hybrid of those to power the house. So, pag walang battery, it gets from the solar or the grid itself. And pag puno yung battery, bumabalik sa grid yung kuryente. Pag puno yung kuryente and nagpo-produce pa ng energy yung solar panel natin, the solar panel is now giving back energy to the grid. And if you apply for net metering, the energy you're providing has a certain peso value, about half the usual rate, and binibili ni grid provider yun. So that's called net metering. To supplement this, we also added a grid-tied system. So basically, wala lang siyang battery. So it only works during the day, it provides energy to the house when there's sun out. But pag hindi rin kailangan ng bahay, the energy produced here is also net metered back into the grid. So this is how we are able to create negative na bill. So yung excess natin na energy is saved to our bill. So when I say negative yung bill namin, hindi ibig sabihin na babayaran kami ng that peso value. It's kind of like meron akong deposit na kuryente that I can get from anytime I may need to use more power in the house. But I know the most important question that everybody has on their mind, is it worth it? Do I go for a hybrid setup or do I go for a grid-tied setup? Etc., etc. Pag-usapin natin. So kanina pinakita ko sa inyo that we have about 3,000 pesos negative when it comes to our bill. That means meron kaming nakabangko na kuryente dito, but I can't use it anywhere else. It's gonna just accrue over time na magne-negative siya. And eventually, if I decide na, sige, bili na lang ako ng electric car para magamit ko yung kuryente, pwede yun. But I cannot say, okay, sobrang dami kong kuryente dito, benta ko na sa iba, or bigay ko sa office namin. Di yan pwede. It's just for this house. But an even more important thing that solar has given us, which is kind of unexpected, can be explained if we go through our bill. So, ito talaga breakdown ng lahat ng bills namin. So, we started off in August. August yung pinakamalayo na makikita natin, August of last year. We were running at around 3,000 pesos. So, 3,000 on August, 3,000 on October. May mali lang din dito if you notice. Itong 12,000, mali yun. Kasi dalawang October na bill. There's something buggy, but I checked, sakto yung 3,000. And then on November, 3,000 pa rin. So we were consistent at 3,000 from about 20 to 30,000 using our hybrid setup. But hindi pa nga namin nakukuha yung zero na gusto namin. And bigla na lang kaming nag 6,000, 6,000, 8,000, 4,000. So biglang tumaas. So I checked. And that was because nagtaas pala ng presyo si power provider. They increased from around 11 pesos. I think now they're at around 16 pesos. Ang laki ng tinaas. So that actually protected us from that inflation. Imagine from 20 to 30,000 kami, if wala kaming solar, ano na yung magiging bill namin? So we decided, okay, dagdag tayo ng grid-tied system, yung walang battery. Dagdagan lang natin to supplement our existing hybrid system para mag-zero talaga tayo. And that is why dito, sa around September and October, nag-zero bill na talaga tayo because this is when we implemented that. If you notice, meron din tayong mga times na nag-29,000, nag-27,000. That was because we were repairing something in our roof, may supplier issue. So we had to take out the solar panels. But once we installed everything, bigla na lang siyang nag-16,000 and now zero na talaga bill natin. And that is the skypod solar journey. But was this whole thing worth it? Number one. Second, how much did you spend for the entire solar? And how long does it take to ROI? Pag-usapan natin. So, was it worth it? Now, our hybrid system cost us about a little over a year ago to. Cost us about mga 2 million pesos. So, 2 million. So that was the solar panels, the inverters, the battery, and everything else. So the ROI with that, especially with the price increase in electricity, is now about mga 6 years. So for me, yes, it was worth it, especially because we now have backup power. So hindi na namin kailangan ng generator, or the generator can be a backup of the backup na. So very, very clean energy. And our grid-tied system, yung walang battery, cost us about 400,000 pesos. So all in all, 2.4 million pesos. But I think it will all in all ROI in around average, would be around 5 years. Depends on mga inflation factors, the sun and everything. But if I were to recommend something to you, whether you choose the one with the battery or without, it would be a choice between how fast you want it to ROI. Siyempre, the battery is one of the most expensive components. Having a battery there gives you that backup power. Make sure that at night, ito rin yung ginagamit natin. But mas mabagal yung ROI, especially with the battery. A battery can last about 7 to 10 years, depending on the type of battery. If ROI lang talaga ang pag-usapan, it would be better to just go for straight grid-tied. But it would be a little bit harder to get to zero bill, especially if you don't have a lot of roof space. So kanina magagamit natin yung pinag-usapan natin, optimizer, but that adds on to the cost. So typically, a grid-tied system, you can ROI in about 4 years. And again, the hybrid system would be about 6 to 7 years, I would say. But then you would have to replace the battery once hindi na siya nag-hold as much charge as it was when it was brand new. So I guess that's it. It really boils down to your choice. Ako, I like having the battery, especially because where we are, palaging nagbo-blackout happens about once a week. And yun, hindi namin nafe-feel, we don't hear the noise, walang amoy, wala kaming i-maintain na gas or diesel. So it was very, very helpful for us. And it's just a good, good feeling na every time you turn on the aircon, alam mong pure, clean energy yung ginagamit namin dito. So that one and the psychology of just, sige, aircon na tayo. Mainit naman eh. Malakas naman yung araw. So that's one of the biggest factors. Of course, there's a big investment up front, but I truly, truly feel that it was worth it. And napansin ko rin that solar items, especially solar panels, are on a downward trend when it comes to expense, which is very, very positive for us, all of us in the future, because it will make it more and more feasible for all of us. So I hope you liked this video. I hope I was able to help you with your decision. If I did, I was helpful, make sure to subscribe, and I'll see you later.